If you told me that when I was a kid that I would eventually manage pavement, I would have given you all the swear words. Right? I started working in roads right away out of school, and pretty quickly I got an opportunity to work at an airport. And this was a very rural airport in a remote part of Africa. I remember we visited a local school, and we were talking with the kids and then asking the kids, oh, hey, what do you want to be when you grow up? And they all said pilot or working at the airport. For them, the airport was kind of a monument, right? It was the gateway to adventure. Pavement design on an airfield is, you know, the utmost and highest standard of pavement. Any irregularity can become a distress in the future. They can either become a projectile or they can be ingested into the aircraft. Mobilizing a construction crew in the middle of an airfield, getting the job done, making sure it's clear and that there's no debris, inspected, commissioned, and then getting the crew off in one night is a feat in itself, right? It has to be planned ahead of time, and you're going to disrupt operations. And the operations have priority on everything. We take a lot of pride into completing our projects, either big or small, it has to get done right. There's a very specific way of managing pavement and going through the process of identifying the distresses, identifying the vintages of pavement, and then analyzing them to find out when they need an investment, either for maintenance, for emergency works, or for capital works for development. When you analyze the life of your pavement and the state that it's in, and the wear that you're going to have with aircraft and vehicles that go about it, how much life do you have left? How much money is it going to cost? When are you going to be spending that money? That's the management aspect of it. Is when is it best to create that capital budget before it's too late and it becomes backlog and a burden on the airport? At Stantec, we have our own proprietary tool that uses the standard procedure for analyzing pavements at airports. And we use this tool to go out in the airfield and do just that, right? To analyze the life of the pavement, how distressed it is, where it is along in its life cycle, so that we can determine when an investment needs to be made. Something that's very important to us in everything, in every project that we do, we want to try to recycle 100% of the materials that are already there on site, or use a product that obviously has lower carbon emissions, has a higher entrapment percentage, and it's always changing, it's always evolving, because we're trending in that direction to try to lower the carbon emissions when we're creating pavement. Technologies for recycling pavement are very useful, hot-in-place recycling, milling and reusing all of the materials into the works that are there, so you reduce trucking, right, off the site and onto the site. Using different types of additives, so that you don't have to produce as much heat to create pavement, right, reduces your carbon emissions as well. It's a very small network of people who are subject matter experts in airports. So we're always bumping into each other at conferences or with clients in meetings, and we interact on projects all the time. I'm always more than happy to let them know about my experience at Stantec, because I just have so much room and freedom to grow and do the things I want to do, to innovate. And to be able to innovate, you need time, and the company allows you the time, right? You can't just copy a solution from one to the next. You have to innovate and create the solution to the problem that you've got. And sometimes companies forget to give you that time. One of the things that I really enjoy now, being part of the team in the leadership position, is that I see some of the other engineers come to the same realization that I did. Right, that the airport sector is something you want to work in, because you have a direct impact to the community that you're in or the community that you're traveling to. It's extremely rewarding.